I want to consider with you the very root and heart of a man's need for professional productivity, to add value to the world around him and be rewarded for doing so. Now, this is an important exercise because I've learned that for many men, this helps open their eyes to a new perspective on personal meaning and purpose. But this will require us to really dig into what it means to be human and how you and I are wired biologically. Until very recently in the history of humanity, that is the last 5,000 years or so, humans did not exist in metropolises or large cities. They didn't even exist in small towns or villages. Throughout the long history of human life, we have lived in small communities of roughly 30 to 50 people. Now, these were clusters of family units who banded together for life existence. In fact, anthropologists tend to refer to these small communities as bands, banded together. Now, a few might call them clans. These were hunter-gatherers and foragers. Some cultivated small gardens, some were nomadic, but most stayed within a small geographic location. So whether this stretched back to the ancient African savanna or the Garden of Eden, this was the basic community structure and system for the vast majority of human existence. 30 to 50 members who depended completely on one another for their very existence. And then most often around the world, several of these band communities cooperated with one another and shared a common language or dialect. They would often gather as one large community or tribe annually to celebrate, share, trade, and make marriage exchanges. The human brain and wiring developed around the band community and the required social norms to keep the band alive. Now, of course, times have changed dramatically, but our biological wiring and instincts have not caught up, not even close. To understand how we think and behave today, we must understand how our ancestors thought and behaved previously. Why we are wired the way that we are. Now, you are who you are today as a man because of who they were. Now, life was not easy in band communities. There were constant threats, a prowling tiger or leopard, a drought, leaving the food resources scarce, a nearby band or warring tribe with very bad intentions. Men had to be able to work together in unison and cooperation to stand strong against these threats. Everyone was needed. We relied on our early brain and limbic system to cope at times. This is one's fight or flight instincts that kick in even without thinking or processing. But humans, in part because of our fragile physical nature, required the use of our more advanced brains, our prefrontal cortex. Now, this allowed us to cooperate and communicate, not only to survive, but to thrive. And there was the act of hunting for food. It is interesting to consider the fact that much of what humans hunted and needed to eat could not be caught by one man alone, not even two. Wild boars, gazelles, and even woolly mammoths. Our forefathers had to work together closely. Every man was needed. And he had to put his skills to work. And the same can definitely be said about war between bands and tribes, which was a constant external threat. Those were the external threats that men faced. But just as important were the internal threats that men faced within his band and even his larger tribe. I call these reputational threats. You see, a man's reputation and standing within the band determined his very existence. He had to bring value to the band, not only because he was needed, but because if he lost favor in the eyes of the community, he risked being shunned or shamed. The pecking order determined everything from choice of mate, cut of meat, from the hunt, garden, or hut location, everything. A man's reputation was everything, and threats to his reputation were literally just as dangerous as external threats. And this is what is so important to understand. Neurologically and biologically, men are, in a sense, programmed to need to prove their value to their peers by adding value to the community. This is the core satisfaction for a man's search for meaning and purpose in life. We must not deny this reality. And this today, of course, translates into our professional lives and careers. I divide these into the two categories of causes and careers. Now, professional success requires an internal will to succeed. And by succeed, I mean find lasting fulfillment, joy, and satisfaction. For some, this includes a competitive drive to close big deals. For others, it's crafting. It's found in crafting an artistic masterpiece that moves the masses. Each requires your will and your initiative to succeed professionally. It requires willfulness, a strong will. Again, for some, this is a competitive act, while for others, it's more cooperative. I will begin to ask you to shift your concept of what it means to be a professional as we journey together. And there's a good chance that if you are considering my consulting platform, you are already professionally successful by most standards. Many of the men I work with are high achievers. Great. But I want to push you beyond the common definition of success to true personal meaning. This will include rediscovering and tapping into your professional passion. Professional passion explodes when a man does four things. First, he knows himself, his strengths, weaknesses, and interests. Second, he applies what he knows about himself to the realms and roles that utilize and capitalize on his strengths and experiences. Now, realms are specific industries and roles that are the best positions with, realms are the specific industries that are best for him, and then roles are the specific positions within the best industry for him. Third, he energetically grows his skills and expertise required to be successful. And then fourth and finally, he applies the constant force of focus and discipline over the long haul to be his best and to give generously of his expertise. Now, for some of you, this might mean stepping up and demanding more of yourself. For others, it might actually mean slowing down or transitioning your effort and attention. For still others, you might need to reevaluate your career in light of an increased focus on your personal life and your relationships. Do not be one of those men who pursue professional success at the expense of your physical health and well-being or your relationships. The top is a lonely place to be when you've burned through your most important relationships. Now here's the good news. I can help. I can. You will do the work and you will open your eyes. I will simply be the lens to help you see yourself and your place in the world in a new way. I'll close with this talk with a return to primitive man. Just as prehistoric men were, you are wired neurologically, biologically, to find deep meaning by serving your community, by adding value. You need to be needed, just as I need to be needed. Anything short of that, of this is a less fulfilling life. Allow me to help you discover the best outlets for your skills, experiences, and passions. You need to do this. You must do this. Let's do it together.